When visiting Rome, it is all too easy to get overwhelmed with the big tourist spots like the Colosseum and St. Peter's Basilica, Trevi Fountain, and Pantheon. Now, those are some absolutely must-see places, of course, but if you're looking for something different, something that's perhaps a little more unique, away from the packed crowds, but still some amazing sights to see in Rome, then you're in the right place. Today, we're sharing some of the best places locals go to escape the crowds. These are the hidden secrets that are not on every tourist's list. So let's go ahead and dive in with 12 unique things to do in Rome that no one else is talking about. Let's start with number one, the Museum and Crypt of the Capuchin Friars. This is also known as the Bone Church. In the center of Rome lies the Museum and Crypt of the Capuchin Friars, which is at once both shocking and frightening. It's a series of small chapels beneath the Church of Santa Maria della Concezione dei Cappuccini. It is built in the 1600s, and the Capuchin crypt houses the remains of around 4,000 friars that were buried by the Capuchin order. This Catholic order was formed almost 500 years ago and still have over 10,000 current members. The Capuchin order believes the remains are a silent and poignant reminder of our mortality. If you would like to visit, Viator has a guided Capuchin crypt tour that ends with a concert that many rave about. It is said to be a bit creepy, but interesting, and the concert at the end is touted to be a beautiful highlight. Next is to take a walk through the Parco degli Acquedotti. On the southeast quadrant of Rome, the Parco degli Acquedotti is an expansive park that features ancient aqueducts that were built during the Roman Empire. It is the remains of 6 of the 11 aqueducts that made the city of Rome famous. The park is now popular with joggers and walkers and became a protected area in the 1980s. Number 3 is to visit the San Lorenzo neighborhood, also known as Rome's most authentic neighborhood. Originally an industrial area, San Lorenzo was heavily bombed during World War II because it was further away from the more important religious sites and the Vatican. Because of this, it's not exactly the prettiest neighborhood, but the neighborhood is well known for its nightlife and food culture. It also houses the Basilica di San Lorenzo Fuori le Mura, one of the 7 pilgrim churches. But if you go, be sure to avoid it from 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. as it is closed during this time. This neighborhood is also home to incredible street art and the best food in Rome. From pizzerias and pasta to sandwiches, coffee, and chocolate, San Lorenzo has the best. The area is also popular with students and young people for the nightlife, great food, and good prices. Moving on, check out an AS Roma versus Lazio soccer match. Known as the Derby della Capitale, the clash between Rome's 2 biggest soccer teams is also one of the biggest soccer rivalries in Europe. Both clubs play out of the Stadio Olimpico, and there is a fierce divide in the city between fans of Lazio's blue and Roma's red. The next highlight is to admire the city from the top of Monte Murillo. The highest hill in modern Rome at over 130 meters tall, but it is not one of the top 7 Roman hills list, which means it's the perfect place to escape overcrowded tourist spots. The hill is home to the Monte Mario Observatory, one of 12 observatories in Rome. You can also visit the Copernicus Museum for ancient astronomical instruments and meteorological tools. You will also find a natural reserve for hiking and walking, as well as 3 churches that date back to the 12th and 14th centuries. The next place is to visit Via Torlonia, a beautifully landscaped arboretum on 32 acres packed with architectural curiosities. It's popular with the locals as a great place for exercise or a picnic, and also contains a decent restaurant, cafe bar, where lunch, dinner, or an aperitivo can be taken in the grounds as beautiful green parakeets fly between cypress trees and date palms. For anyone looking for a uniquely Roman experience that is near the city center, yet completely removed from the tourism industry, Torlonia is truly an unmissable visit. In the early 1800s, the wealthy banker Giovanni Torlonia had an accomplished architect, who also happened to be Rome's urban planner, design a park in the English picturesque style. On the land he had purchased, he then built a vast white mansion in the middle of it. After his death, his son began commissioning various odd buildings all over the park, a habit his son then continued after his death. So between the two offspring, there's nearly a century of bizarre buildings, including a fake temple, fake basilica, fake mosque, and a hodgepodge of styles. Today, this public park is free to visit and open during daylight hours. Next is the Mercatus Traiani, also known as Trajan's Market. The Roman Empire expanded to its largest size under Trajan's rule, and the Mercatus Traiani is thought to be the world's oldest shopping mall, thought to be built around 105 AD. The market had multiple levels and included shops, apartments, and a library. The next is to eat at Trattoria da Enzo al 29. The small eatery with sidewalk tables is located close to the River Tiber. It serves a variety of classic Roman dishes and it is open Monday through Saturday, and there's no reservations. So they open at 12:15 for lunch, at 7 for dinner, and then you need to try to get there as early as possible because this is a very, very popular spot for the locals. In fact, it has been written up in the New York Times, the Louis Vuitton City Guide, Vanity Fair, and so many other publications. It is a must-eat restaurant, but again, be sure to be there early because it will be crowded. Next is a visit to the Ponte Nomentano. The Ponte Nomentano is a pedestrian bridge that spans almost 200 feet across the Aniene River, which is a tributary of the Tiber. Different parts of the bridge were completed in different eras, from medieval to modern age. The bridge's unique architecture has provided inspiration for artists since its inception. Though it is near the modern districts of Nomentano and Monte Sacro, it still preserves its rural tranquility. Next is a visit to the Nymphaeum of Egeria. This is also the Parco Regionale dell'Appia Antica, the largest urban protected area in Europe. It is covered by lush greenery, and this green wedge runs from the city center all the way towards Castello Romani. In the center is the Regina Viarum, an open-air museum winding over 16 kilometers and always accessible. It also houses the remains of the imperial villas and aqueducts. The Nymphaeum of Egeria was built in the 2nd century by Roman politician Herodotus Atticus to honor his wife. Some scholars believed that this was the site of a spring and sacred wood where King Numa Pompeius met with the nymph of Egeria. Next is a visit with the cats at the Largo di Torre in Argentina. This site was excavated in the 1920s, which revealed four temples that are now 20 feet below street level. Stray cats moved in immediately after the site was excavated, and nowadays most of the 100-plus cats have special needs or are disabled and are cared for by the gattare, or cat ladies, who feed and take care of them. Cats can be seen lounging around on ancient steps and pillars, and there is even an underground gift shop. Finally, we have a visit to the Tarpeian Rock. The Tarpeian Rock is a steep cliff that was used for centuries as an execution site during the Roman Republic. People who committed crimes deemed worthy of being tossed off the rock were thrown 25 meters down to their deaths, and the site was used until the late 1st century. If you're planning to visit Rome this year, take a look at this video that talks about how to plan an amazing trip just like the pros do. And other than that, I want to thank you so much for stopping by. Have a great Roman holiday, and we will see you on the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.